Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to talk about the synthesis of incargranine A, an alkaloid that features a 2-2-2 bicyclooctane core with 6 contiguous stereocenters. To synthesize this natural product, the authors took advantage of a previously proposed biosynthetic pathway from this hemiaminal. This pathway consists of a retro-oxa-Mannich, oxa-Michael, keto-enol tautomerization, and Mannich cascade. This key intermediate could be reached by a chemoselective reductive cyclization of a tertiary amide bearing a pendant tertiary alcohol via the iminium ion formed in situ. The amide group could be accessed from this spirocycle by selective cleavage of the lactone and decarboxylation of the resultant carboxylate. The spirocycle was generated by an enantio and diastereoselective Michael addition from a racemic dienon that could be disconnected back to two simple fragments, a disubstituted cyclohexadienon and this malonamic acid. The synthesis begins with a Ullmann coupling between the aryl bromide and pyrrolidinone using catalytic copper iodide and dimethyl ethylenediamine to give the coupled product in near-quantitative yield. The Ullmann-type reaction is a sort of copper-catalyzed nucleophilic aromatic substitution between nucleophiles such as amines with aryl halides. The reaction is an alternative to the Bagwell-Harvick amination, which is catalyzed by palladium. Aryl iodides, bromides, and chlorides are good substrates with the following reactivity trend. The opposite trend is observed in uncatalyzed SNR reactions. The primary alcohol was then protected with paramethoxybenzyl. Alpha acylation of the lactam was carried out using sodium HMDS and diethyl carbonate to afford the ethyl ester. Saponification of the ester under aqueous basic conditions, followed by acidification, delivered the carboxylic acid fragment. The carboxylic acid was then coupled with an alcohol via Steglic reaction under standard coupling conditions. This Steglic esterification allows the reaction between alcohols and carboxylic acids with dicyclohexyl carbodiimide, DCC, as a coupling reagent, and dimethylaminopyridine, DMAP, as a catalyst. The alcohol was synthesized in two steps by primary alcohol TBS protection, followed by hypervalent iodine oxidation of the resultant phenol. The next step is an enantioselective organocatalyzed Michael addition. This enantioselective desymmetrization reaction was carried out with bifunctional iminophosphorane organocatalysts, which can promote rapid and highly enantioselective Michael additions of pronucleophiles such as this cyclohexadienon. BIMP catalysts are a class of chiral organocatalysts comprising an hydrogen bond donor moiety and a strongly basic iminophosphorane linked through a chiral backbone. The protonation of the malonamate ester by the BIMP catalyst results in a stereoselective Michael addition to the enon. The next step was to perform the chemoselective hydrolysis of the lactone moiety in the presence of the neighboring lactam. Hydrolysis using potassium hydroxide in ethanol showed little discrimination for the lactone. After further investigation, the authors found that trimethylsilanoate showed remarkable reactivity for the lactone cleavage, even in the presence of the fused lactam. The desired product was then obtained following telescoped thermal decarboxylation of this intermediate. The product was obtained in 49% yield as an inconsequential 2-to-1 mixture of diastereomers. The final transformation involved the key reductive cyclization to form a hemiaminal from the alcohol tethered lactam. The desired hemiaminal was obtained by a chemoselective iridium catalyzed reduction of an amide to produce acylated hemiaminal. This compound eliminates to form the corresponding aluminium ion, to which the pendant alcohol adds, furnishing the cyclic hemiaminal. For the reaction, a modified Bascas complex and acylene reductant tetramethyl disiloxane were used. On the other hand, directly treating the reaction mixture with dry HCl in 1,4-dioxane achieved the desired reactivity. It led to the deprotection of the TBS group and triggered the retro-oxa-Mannich, oxa-Michael, Mannich cascade in a single step. Concurrent PMB deprotection gave incargranine A in 41% yield, along with the PMB-protected product in 18% yield, which could be readily deprotected using trifluoroacetic acid. Also, when each diastereomer was independently subjected to the reductive cyclization conditions, the depicted product was isolated as the measured product. This highlights that the reductive cyclization reaction might proceed with epimerization through the corresponding enamine intermediate. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe, like, or leave me a comment down below. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!